So I'm very happy to say I just finished reading my 65th book this year. And one of the things that I found, like even in research, is that when you read fiction books, for example, you create an empathic bond with the character because you can chesed. You can get inside their minds. You can think with their thoughts. You can see through their eyes. You can cry through their tears. You can hear with their ears. You can walk in their sandals. You can create an empathic bond with Katniss Everdeen as you march to the beat of her heart, right? Like that's one of the things that reading does for you, is it creates empathy. But also the genre I read the most this year was actually nonfiction, because sometimes in reading someone else's POV, it helps me to get a clearer perception of the world. Like I just finished a book today by Thomas Stearns Eliot. And when I read of like the damp soul of housemaids, picturing like a Dickensian morning where a housemaid is waiting at the gate and she's there in the damp with her damp laundry, like the damp soul of a housemaid, or nothing behind the eye of the child thief, like a vacuity behind the eye, or our friend, the sentimental moon, right? Our friend, the sentimental moon, because the moon is quite nostalgic, or giving an aimless smile. Like when I see that view of the world, nihilistic though it might feel, it helps me to not feel so alone. And that's one of the benefits of reading. That's one of the powerful things of reading. So I really want to encourage you to be somebody who reads. Now, a book that I've been reading over and over again lately is Carl Gustav Jung's The Undiscovered Self, which I've been talking about here and there quite a bit actually. But if Jung is indeed and in sooth correct in his presumption that we are, through, again, dialectic reasoning, a diminutive, miniature Lilliputian translation of the cosmos, then that means that although we are little evil devils, the fact is, Winston Churchill said, I may be a worm, but I dare say I'm a glowworm. We are glowworms that have the capacity to aspire. We can aspire higher. You say, why is it important that we aspire? Because if you can aspire, that means you can see a form. That means you can see the woodwork model against which you can sculpt your own stone. You can see the Platonic ideal, the form, the model and quintessence upon which you want to model your life. And that can take you higher. Like if you can aspire, that takes you higher. It really does. I know that's a cute little rhyme, but it really does work. So that's no small feat. Hence, like if the macrocosm is embossed and superimposed and imprinted upon our soul and upon our being with the psyche behind it all along, that means the galactic deeps are reflected in our ability to reflect upon it. Isn't that cool? The universe understanding itself through our own mind, through our logos. So when you learn about Enceladus, I pronounced it wrong the other day, but Enceladus, it's icy water vapors shooting up volcanically at 800 miles an hour, this moon around Saturn, which actually helps these water vapors to form Saturn's outer ring, right? Or S2, remember Sagittarius A, another amendment, is the black hole in the center of the Milky Way, but S2 hits 2% light speed, this star going around the Sagittarius A black hole, the middle of the Milky Way galaxy, zooming around the black hole, or the splendiferous magnificence of supernovae, like supernovae. You realize that these are the white shadows cast by our ability to aspire. Aspiration does make redemption possible. And so these are things that you learn when you read the right books. And I want to encourage you not so much to read people's commentaries on the great, unless you're reading Nietzsche on, you know, the Homer and classical philology, or Thomas Stearns Eliot on, you know, a poet from England over the last 100 years. Like if you're gonna read a classic author talking about classic authors like Samuel Johnson or whatever your thing is, that's great. But like, let's go back to the horse's mouth and let's learn from the originals. And as we do so, like, who knows what amazing new ideas we're gonna come up with.